Hello, welcome to Healthy Bones and Balance. This is an exercise class sponsored by the Amherst Senior Center and taught live on Monday and Wednesday mornings at 10 a.m. on Zoom. You can check with the Amherst Senior Center for the link. My name is Jaymie Chernoff. My partner Betsy Howlett teaches, and there are more of us who teach in the classes when we're at home at the Bank Center. But right now we're moving on Zoom. Movement is what it's all about. It's what we need at every age, different kinds of movement. And particularly for people who have some osteopenia, osteoporosis, we offer a safe place to do the exercise. And exercise, movement, actually weight-bearing exercise, is the only natural way to increase bone density as we grow older. It's natural to lose some bone density, but it takes effort to build it back. The only natural way to increase bone density is increase the pull of muscle on bone. So we work our muscles to pull on the bone, to grow bones, and it's got all the other benefits of exercise too. And in the live class, we really have a sense of being together in a group of 40, 50 of your neighbors and friends who are making a commitment to keep moving, keep building strengths through pandemics and blizzards and whatever comes. So let's just get started. This class can be done completely seated and I'll be demonstrating. We do two sets of each exercise, and I'm gonna do the first set in the chair and the second set standing. You can mix and match as you like. We do use weights when we're ready. So if it's your first class, just use your own fist and your own resistance, no weights. You might add after that a 1 or 2 pound weight, you could hold a juice can and begin to add effort to your work. And we also have leg weights. You'll see I'll be using them in the class, and you can contact us for more information about what kinds of weights and so forth. So enough with the talking, let's get moving. A seated warm up, and you can adapt the standing. I'm just going to march in place. Lifting my knees, I have to lean back a little bit, trying to keep my back straight. I could be going slower or faster. Now I'm going to just adapt it by left foot down and tapping out to the side with first one foot, the other hand. And then, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, flat, out to the side. Any kind of way you're moving your legs is good. Your Broadway kicks, and bring it down. Little back bend, moving my chair just so you can see I'm holding onto the side of the chair, lifting the chest, deepening the curve in my lower back, and taking my shoulders back and down. Might keep the arms up in cactus and breathe. And centering myself on the chair. Left hand up, right hand holding onto chair seat, rooting my sit bones and reaching to the side. Gotta press down with my left hip as I reach away. Inhale up, right arm up, lengthen. Hip bone press, sit bone presses down, fingers reach up, and then to the other side, use your legs to add stability as you're pressing into the floor. Let your neck be free, and inhale up. And now we'll begin with the bicep curls. So I'm picking up weights, and as I said, first set I'll do seated,
sitting comfortably away from the chair back, knees right over my ankles, feet about hip distance apart, arms are long. I inhale to prepare and I exhale, bend at the elbow, raising the weights upper toward my shoulders and then slowly down, palms up. And that's one. So the upper arms really stay right where they are. Two, three, inhale, four, inhale, five, inhale, six. We move slowly because it's more work, and more work is good for us. Seven, inhale, eight, inhale, nine, inhale, 10. I'm trying to keep my back and torso still. 11 and 12, and end by going slowly, slowly down, and then rest your weights on your legs. See if they're secure, shake the hands out for a minute. We'll go on to the second set. You can continue in a seated position. You could also alternate, do one and then two for the second set and go through to modify your effort. If it's, if you're just joining us. So now I'll do the second set standing. As you stand, it takes a little more effort in the core to stabilize yourself with the weights, but the exercise is the same. Inhale, turn the palms forward, and exhale, bend at the elbow, and inhale down. Exhale with the effort, inhale down. Three, inhale, four, inhale, five, six, inhale, seven, inhale, eight, inhale, nine, 10, 11, and now the last one, the second set, 12. Don't rush it, even maybe slow it down a little more. Good work. Shake the hands out and actually add a hand exercise, interlacing my fingers and just loosely pulling, turning, stretching out, and little thumb rubs. Now our next is strength building and aerobics, so stand up, sit down. So we all begin at a chair, and I'm looking for my timer because this, we don't count it, but we do the exercise for 30 seconds and you keep your own count. You might do however many, you keep track and you'll know over time whether you're getting more into that 30 seconds or, well, you will get more. All right. So the exercise starting seated, and you can, you're going to stand up and sit down. That's it. So, and you're going to just do it again and again until I call time. And you can use your hands to help push off. You can rest your hands here. If you feel stronger, you could reach your hands up or fold the hands. All right. Ready and go. Let your weight really come down in that chair. Halfway there, more than half. And 30. Good going. That gets us warmed up. Big hands out. Reach up. Maybe hold on to the forearms and reach, kind of squiggle to the side a little bit and float down. Now we will put on our leg weights if you're using them and begin with ham curls, which is a standing exercise. Some of our leg exercises need to be done while standing. And your leg weights can start at half pound weights or 1, 2, 3 and go up from there gradually, adding effort. Because when your body gets used to a movement and a certain weight over time, it doesn't serve to prompt bone building. We always want to surprise the bones. That's our goal. Surprise it with a little more effort each time. So ham curls, you're facing the chair back, or it could be a wall. And I'm gonna lift my right foot, slightly flex the foot, curl the toes, keeping my thighs even, and down, working this big hamstring muscle at the back of my thigh, my right thigh. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Squeeze your belly in as you go up to 9, 10, 11, and 12. We'll continue on. Second set. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, done one leg. Up on the toes, roll back on the heels, up and down, and stand steady. Put the weight on the right foot as you begin to lift the left, bend the knee, flex the foot, curl the toes, and press that knee back so it's not here, it's right there. And continue. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So that's our first set. Now, even without strapping on weights, you can add weight with visualizing something as we begin the second set. Uno. Think of a hand or a heavy, big, heavy weighted pillow resting on your back of your ankle that you're going to press up. 3, or move through molasses. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and last one is 12. Roll up, maybe bend the knees and do a little hip circle. Release those hamstrings. And we'll go to the next arm exercise, which is triceps, working the muscle at the back of the arm. I'm gonna do the first step in the seated position. It's really the same exercise. And I begin holding the weight in my right hand at the right hip. And I roll my shoulders back. And you'll see my upper arm should stay still while I extend the lower arm. For 1, 2, inhale, exhale, 3, inhale, 4, inhale, 5, my back is straight, 6, 7,
8, 9, 10. Feel your whole body working to support you. 11 and 12. And return, first set on the right side. Shake the hand for a minute and quick pick up again. En français. Deux, trois, quatre, cinq. Remember, you can be doing every other one. Six, sept, huit, neuf, dix. Two more. Onze and douze. Hold, hold, hold. The hand droops. And shoulder circles feel good right here. And now we'll switch to the second side, and I'm demonstrating standing. Continue seated or standing. So now I'm on my left side, and right leg further in front, and I'm gonna bend that front leg. I'm still keeping a straight line. Left hand to left hip. Roll the shoulder back and ready to leave the upper arm still while extend for one. Press two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Lift up, nine. Extend, lift, 10, 11, 12, and pause for a moment, maybe shoulders up to the ears and melt down, shoulders up, melt down, shoulders up, melt down. You can do every other one, or you can push on second set, two, uno, due, tre, quattro, cinque, sei, sette, otto, nove, dieci, undici, dodici. And that's triceps. Put the weight down, shake them out. You can give a little squeeze so this muscle feels good. Go away all the way up the shoulders. And back leg raise. We move throughout the whole body. Everything gets worked in this simple set. So let's keep moving. Back leg raise is gonna really work our glutes, our back of our legs, power us for walking, hill walking. And begin by shifting the weight to the left foot and slide the right foot back. And you might, and then we'll lift up and you really feel that full, strong muscle engagement. If you're beginning and it's too much to lift up, you'll get the effort right here. Just visualize yourself energetically lift up even without it moving. Okay, let's do one, inhale. Two, and really squeeze at the top there. Squeeze that butt muscle. Three, inhale. Four, trying to keep my torso straight. Five, six, seven, eight, nine. Can work on balance at the same time. 11 and 12. Pause, stretch our ankles, roll it up and back on our feet. Second set. Anna, Vio, Tria, Tessera, Pende, Exi, Epta, Squeeze, Octo, Enea. Veka, Enveka, Lodeka, and
take a break. That's two sets on the right. Just bending the knees, kind of hanging there, a little calf stretch, belly in. So regulars will know we often count the second set in another language. So we remember it was the second set. And to get in a little variety. All right, now, same thing with the right here, left leg. Standing on the right, lifting up the left leg and pressing back slowly so I really feel the action of engagement and lift and power there. Return. Two, slow return. Slide, lift. Four, belly goes in right here. Five, you really need it to power that up. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Hold, squeeze, 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 rock hard butt, and down. Maybe bend one knee, then the other. And we do our second set, left leg. Spanish again. Uno. Dos. Tres. There's no advantage in hurrying. Cuatro. Cinco. All the advantage comes from going slow. Seis. Siete. Ocho, nueve, diez, once, last one, make it good, doce, and back, and bend the knees, put your hands on your knees to lift your sit bones up, or right here at the chair, go into a kind of L pose, bend the knees again, and then slowly take the thighs back. You can still have a soft bend in the knee, but you have a nice, delicious pull on those gluteus maximus muscles and the stronger hamstrings. And bend the knees and come up. Let's flick our fingers just like a fist that goes out. January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August. Shake. And now we will all sit for this arm exercise. Take your hand weights if you're using them. And this is the seated row. So I'm sitting away from the chair back, as almost always. Feet hip distance apart, 90 degree bend of the knee. Inhale, taking my weights and reaching forward with them. So my torso, this is no strain on the back because I'm going hinging right at the hip crease and there's nothing rounded, never rounded the back in our exercises. And take the weights forward so they're near the calf. And then take a big inhale, power up, and then exhale, bend the elbows and lift them up and they carry the weights with them. And down. Two, inhale. Three, inhale. Four, inhale. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Hold and pause. Rest. Maybe shoulder blades up to the ears and drop down. Maybe take the right ear to the right shoulder. A little stretch in the left side of the neck, just release it to gravity. Inhale up and take left ear to left shoulder. And try to keep tension out of your neck in the exercise. Inhale, second set. Beginning point. Inhale your power and lift for one. Or say 12, we'll come backwards. 11. 10. 9. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3, 2, and let's hold when we get up there. 1, 1, 1, and release. Weight resting weights on your legs. And put them down. And we'll all stay seated for the next exercise, but let's do a twist for variety in the middle. Inhale, lengthen up, just like visualizing my armpits lifting away from my hips, shoulders dropping down, and pressing my feet into the floor. I turn towards the right, rest my hands, and really visualizing your spine just in a staying a perfect straight line with the vertebrae just twisting around it. It's healthy, it's safe for people with osteoporosis, osteopenia, and it's a great way to exercise the spine, to give a relief, to give movement, joint movement to the vertebrae in a different way than usual. Up again, and it's the inhaling and lengthening, creating space, and then moving into the twist. And as you create more length, pressing down on your sit bones, reaching up with the crown of the head, you're creating more space for the discs, and everything can breathe better. The power of our visualization in activating our body in different ways is great. So visualizing the energetic action that we're about to take is a tool for athletes. Before they do the high jump, they're rehearsing it, they're feeling it, all muscles are going through their readiness, and we do it too, almost naturally, if you allow it and add your awareness. So next, knee extension, leg extension. So it's, some of us like to hold rubber balls if you have them. It's not really not a weight thing. It's just give them more squeeze, hand exercise. So I'm going to sit at, if I sit back a little more, I'm still not touching the back of the chair. I'm going to extend my right leg and point, flex, and come back. That'll be one. The if you're building up your strength, you maybe won't leave the foot off the ground. You might just go forward. Or you might go forward and up a couple inches. And you're going to, I mean, I'm feeling that right there in my front of my thigh, the quad muscles, which is our target. So we want to move slowly. We don't use momentum, we use our own muscle strength. So we'll do 12 rep sets on each side. Inhale and reach out with the heel, point, flex, and return. 2. Point, flex, back. 3, point, flex, return. 4, point, flex, return. Reach through the heel for 5, 6, 7, feel the heat, 8, inhale, 9, inhale, 10, inhale, 11, inhale, and 12, and back. And now one of the reasons the balls are great to tap on the thigh with, you can also use your fists. Now we'll do essentially the same thing, so we'll circle our ankles for variety at the apex of the movement. Inhale your power, exhale it out, reach for the heel, circle, and return. 11, 10, try to keep your torso erect, 9, that's a good core part of the exercise, 7, reach, circle, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And you can kind of, feels good to me to have that go up on the ball of my foot and just kind of swing the knee in and out as a release, the right knee. So now left leg's ready to go. 90 degrees. Inhale and reach to the left heel. Press towards straight, point, flex, and return. 2, point, flex, return. 3, point, flex, return. Torso stays upright. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Tap, tap, tap. Now, a key strategy, if you start to feel tired, you think, I can't get through this whole set, modify, change, take it down a bit. Slide your foot out with a tiny lift. Avoid it at all possible, not stopping. Just reduce the effort to something that you can tolerate. And when you're ready, come back in. Second set. Inhale, reach your height, sit bones are down, crown of the head reaching tall, creating more space. Uno, inhale. Dos, circle the ankle. Tres. Cuatro. Cinco. Seis. Siete. Ocho. Nueve. Diez. Once. Doce. Glad to welcome 12 in any language. I'm going to put my knees wide, rest my forearms, lift my sit bones so my back is straight, and come down a little bit. I'm pressing my elbows against my inner knees and vice versa, and allows my chest maybe drop a little further. And inhale up. Just review this important point, back, lower back, ease. If you ever feel stress, strain, pulling there, just stop because you can change your position. So as I hinge forward for anything, what I mean is like I'm folding like a piece of paper right at the hip creases. And the sit bones have to lift. The back of my sit bones are off the chair now. And that allows me to keep natural lower back curve and come forward with a straight and safely moving spine. You'll hear that again and again. So let's see, balls away, and we'll take up our hand weights for overhead press. This one, we advise everyone to do seated because we're taking the weights up and it's hard to maintain our stability. I'll do an angle so you can see. So we lift the weights out to the side. Elbows are out to the side and press up. This is like those big weightlifters that you see with the big long, you know what I mean, two. And we just press up. It goes up, but it doesn't go back like here, or that's unstable. It's right, it's at an angle. Press three, inhale. This is how you get the kayak up on the car. Four, inhale. Five, or pressing the box up on the shelf for six, seven, eight. Remember, you can alternate. Nine, 10, 11, 12, and rest for set. So that's a healthy modification. You keep moving, you keep effort going, but you just take it down a notch. And if you've been away from class for a while, you need to step back and, you know, take those modifications before you catch up with where you were before and start moving ahead. Second step, en français. Inhale. Deux. Inhale. Trois. Inhale. The weight slightly in front. Quatre. Cinq. Six. Sept. Huit. Neuf. Dix. Onze. Douze. And that feels good. It feels good to stop. I mean, even if you like exercising, it always feels good to stop, no doubt about that. All right, let's stand up for a moment and bend our knees and take a hula hoop hip circle and other side. And then standing, feet reach up, interlace the fingers and press up and reach up and feel your leg, feel it pull up on your belly and hips out of your thighs, waist out of your hips, midriff out of your waist, and so on. Reach. And now we'll do side leg raise. Our lateral movement and the muscles on our side are really important to us. Something you can do at home is just walk sideways along your kitchen counter or around the island, or but we do it more intensely here with weights in our side leg raise. So I'm using the chair just for balance, shifting my weight to my left foot. Lift the right foot, turn the toe in. Really, it's a very pigeon-toed right now as you lift it out to the side. That targets the right muscle that we're after. And then slowly squeeze back. So there's no swinging. Swinging's for kids. Inhale, turn, and then lift. Feel you're pressing a big weight out. And then here you've got a big balloon you're starting to squeeze the air out of to bring back in. Three, squeeze. Four, squeeze. Five, squeeze. Six, seven, squeeze it back. Eight, nine, 10. Yeah, you're doing it. 11, 12, pause. Roll up the feet, Maybe bend the knees. We'll hang there with a calf stretch. Second set. Uno. Don't rush. Exhale. Inhale. Or dos. Tres. Squeeze back. Cuatro. Cinco. Seis. Siete. Ocho. Nueve. Diez. Once. Press into the standing leg. Lift up. Doce. Doce. Here we are. Just came upon us. So, as I'm bending one knee, then the other, you can feel it pulling on those side lateral leg muscles. Ooh, so good. Now, left leg standing on the right and really press into the floor with the right, lifting up, pull in your right hip. So you're no sagging here. Up, press, left foot toe turns in and lift. See, it gets straight when it's out there with a two, inhale, three, inhale. You can give a small bend in the standing knee, standing leg. Four, inhale, five, inhale, six, inhale, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Slow back. Okay, one more step. This is our last leg exercise. Enjoy it. Ooh, uno, due, tre, cuatro, cinque Antonio's pizzas. Sei, sette, otto, nove. Don't rush, don't rush. Get every dollop. Dieci, is that right? Undici, and dodici. If you got an extra one, consider yourself lucky. If you missed one, take it, do it right now. And we can take off our leg weights because we have one more arm, hand exercise and some balance work. So feel, just feel the vibration of your body, the heat. We're building muscles, but we're also moving the fascia, all the wrapping of the organs and inside the skin, all the places that get sticky with lack of movement. They're fluid and juiced up. Speaking of fluid, drink water before class, drink water during class. I've not been modeling it because thinking of other things, but I'm talking too, so I really need to drink. Just think of bathing all the internal parts move better with fluid, with lubrication. So our next last weighted exercise is with hand weights, and we've come to call it the marionette exercise, but showing it without weights for a moment. So we're a series of 90 degree angles, ankles under the knees, shoulders right over the hips, straight back. And I'm going to hold the weights right here. I'm going to lift elbows and forearms so that my wrist, elbow, and shoulder are approximately at one level and down. So take it with the weights and Already, it's a work right here. Belly to the spine, inhale, power. Exhale, lift. For one, two, inhale. Three, try to keep your shoulders down. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, and down. So one more weighted set to this class of healthy bones and movement. Great. Inhale. Anna. Inhale. Vio. Inhale. Tria. Inhale. Tessera. Pende. Exi. Epta. Octo. Enea. Veka. Two more. Andika. Lodika. And come down. Wow. Good work. Good work, all of us. Here we go. A tap. Pat on the back. Squeeze that trapezius muscle, top of the shoulder. Woo. It's a good workout, but it's our job. Getting older is what comes with it. Can't take strength for granted. We've got to go out and meet it halfway. So strength is checked off and balance. Being stronger is already working on your balance because you've had to balance your torso while your weights are putting a new pressure on it. But this is more direct. Your chair or wall, shift the weight to left leg and lift the right one. You can have a balance experience even while your toes are touching. My toes are touching there, but so lightly, pressing the heel against the ankle. And I can lift it up, you know, like a quarter of an inch and feel the wobble and find the balance. I'm pressing that the thigh of the hip of my standing leg in, and you might put your heel up further. And we'll do 30 seconds approximately. Keep pressing into the midline. Feel all of your body energy moving to that golden line from the left heel to the crown of the head. You might take your top of your big thigh back, thigh bone back a little bit. So it's really right aligned over the ankle as opposed to being having the hip over the arch of your foot. And then stretch up your sternum and down. And a little wiggle, shaking, release. And other leg. Stand on the right. So slouch into it first. See what slouch, remind yourself if you've forgotten what the slouch feels like. Oh, it feels good, but it isn't really good. So press in, thigh bone back. So it's right over the ankle, not hinging forward right there, and find your place of balance. And if you want to reach up, you can keep a hand, one up, one down. That's a good idea. Belly in. And just think about stacking the blocks of your bones and weight. Like a child builds the stack of blocks. If they're aligned, that's half the work of balance, and you're not using as much muscle to do it. And if you lose balance, just find it again. Lose, find. That's the practice. Lose, find. Reach, reach, climb,
maybe climb, hold on to ropes at the top of the gym. And release. Oh. Now some of the best part is getting to stretch those worked muscles. So I'm sitting in the chair, dropping my facing, well, left knee is forward, right knee's back, right thigh's perpendicular to the floor, back toes curled under, and pressing the back toes into the floor, reaching towards the floor with the right knee. I'm stretching this back thigh muscle. I can have more support with the chair. And move back until the point where you feel that's sufficient stretch sensation. And you're keeping that back foot, the back leg active. So you're not pulling a soft thigh muscle, you're pulling an engaged muscle, like pressing into the back toes, reaching with the knee. And come up. Should feel pretty good. And you may have a great stretch right here. We're all so different in which muscles are tight and worked. So same principle, pressing down now with the left toes curled under, left knee, like reaching in here, a little back bend. And inhale. And pause. Take the right arm across, reach, and you're going to use the other arm to pull it in and pull. So the outside of your right shoulder, where your arm bone meets the ball socket, gives it a nice pull opposite to what we've been doing. And switch sides across, reach, maybe pull back with that left shoulder. You can do finger flicks while you're here. Time's running out in our hour of power. Tricep stretch, reach up and bend the elbow and take the hand back. Could stay in a modified quad stretch even. So I'm reaching my hand, walking it with the fingers down the back a little bit. I'm noticing that my ribs are lifting up, so I'm going to take my front legs down again, lift the back ribs up a little bit, and then press down, take the left hand, press down on the right elbow, maybe press it back a little bit to intensify the stretch as you need to. We really should hold the stretch for like 6 seconds minimum to allow the muscles to respond. But you can do more when we finish together. So again, now left arm, left elbow bends, goes back, reaches down, and hand plugs that upper arm bone into the shoulder socket, and so then it can safely press back even more. And reach and come down. Let's just do shoulder circles. So this is just what our Monday and Wednesday classes are, 10 a.m. Call the Senior Center for Zoom, reverse. And you'll find a continual series of videos here. But, it's good to keep moving, whether you're seeing a recorded class or with us live, pressing down with the feet. Inhale up. It's going to take a moment to celebrate your commitment to movement and your and the vibration and energy that movement gives you. Yes, I hope you're tired. That would be a good workout.
but the energy, the internal energy is building. Thanks so much. See you again. Healthy Bones and Balance.